First of all, how do you feel about returning to Bucharest for the Unforgettable Festival?
It's a real pleasure. I think it's going to be a great evening, so it's exciting for me, especially that this year I'm way more in studio, so I don't perform much. So I'm happy I'm going to have the chance to see people and get out of my forest where my studio is.
What memories do you have from your previous concerts in Bucharest?
Great memories, because that's it, while traveling and everything, I think Romanians are incredible people, and I even have two very good friends here in Canada that are from Romania. And so it's great. I know a bit about it, but they were not born in Romania, but they're from Romanian parents. And so I'm always excited to go and see where they come from.
How is your relationship with your Romanian fans? How do you feel the connection between you and them at this moment?
I haven't been in Romania much, so for me it's still in the quest of discovering that relationship. Still, I've had warm welcome so far, so I'm excited to go again, and I know I'm not going to be alone, so there's great performers on the show. So
exactly.
I feel it's going to be a great evening.
You'll share the stage at the Unforgettable Festival with Lara Fabia, Chiara Di Bari, Daniel Lavoie, Julien Dassin. Might we expect some amazing duets like Sous le Vent or even Belle from Notre Dame de Paris?
Sous le Vent is definitely in the project.
Okay.
While singing a duet, and it's been such a long time that I've been wanting to find the right moment to do it with Laura. It's 6 o'clock, is it? Je donne des vacances à mon cœur, un peu de repos. It would be the worst rehearsal ever if we don't do it in the concert. So I'm pretty sure we will do it in the concert. And we're preparing something with Lara that we never did before. We did sing together, but it's a song that I've never sung before. So I won't tell you what it is because it might change. But it's a great French song that I love, but I never had the opportunity to sing it. And Belle should be on the program too, and I'm so happy because I've seen Daniel Lavoie. I hadn't seen him for a couple of years. Belle, est-ce le diable qui s'est incarné en... And I've seen him like 10 days ago. We did a concert in Quebec together, and we sang Belle again together, and I've been such a long time, and every time there's something magical about this song, and it's hard to explain, but singing it together is like, wow. For me, it's my, Daniel is my big brother.
And Patrick Fourier is your little brother?
Patrick is my little brother. We're very close brothers. With Patrick. Daniel, I don't see him much, but since I started my career with Belle, it's the first song I ever recorded in my life, so it did change my life. Funny enough, the day before yesterday, Luc Plamondon was at my house. We had dinner together, and...
Wonderful.
And he, I was telling him again, you really changed my life with that song.
Let's talk about a little bit about Notre Dame de Paris, because as you said, it was a career defining moment for you. How do you reflect on that experience right now? How was Quasimodo then? How has Quasimodo's character stayed with you over the years?
It stayed in my physical, because I really did hurt myself physically doing the role. I had a problem with my knee, my left knee, that an accident that I had before, and I decided to put everything on that knee, all
my pain. I need to feel pain to incarnate, to feel what Quasimodo was feeling. He was hurt all the time, like mentally and physically. So I did really hurt myself physically. Thank God I still walk. But I don't walk like Quasimodo anymore. But Quasimodo is definitely a part of me, because when Luc Plamondon asked me to do the incredible role of the Hunchback, it was I was surprised, because I was like, Quasimodo is a sad character. He's a lost character. He's not a social character. And I am pretty much the opposite of that. I'm very social, I have lots of friends, always happy in life. I was doing rhythm and blues music and, you know, in clubs and performing with great musicians. And so it was really like a composition role to go in that sadness, that darkness, that it was pain. Really special. So it did stay into me to open up my my panel of emotions, I would say.
Do you consider returning to the theater for another major role in a musical in the future?
I am planning my what could be, but it's still research and development. I'm thinking of my own concert would become a lot more theatrical. The next one, of course, I would always consider, but since that Notre Dame de Paris was fantastic, then I did another role with Cirque du Soleil at Radio City Musical in New York on Broadway, which was a great experience as well to do that huge concert with Cirque, because they're close friends of mine, and it was a great experience to again do something theatrical, but it was not the same. Notre Dame was really an incredible experience. And with Daniel Lavoie, we were talking about it, saying, I was telling him, it's like I don't remember that much. It's like it was another life, because we're really into the story and really believing we were becoming the characters. Daniel still does it once in a while. So I was asking him, I don't know how you do it, because I wouldn't be able to go back to Quasimodo for weeks or months.
Your perspective did change that much since Notre Dame de Paris. I mean, who were you back then? Who are you now?
A lot of people tell me, a lot of people around me, they tell me the greatest thing about you is that you didn't change much. Hopefully it's true. I'm still into, you know, simple things. I've been fortunate in my life, like crazy people I've met, trips that I did. Of course, I come from a family that don't travel much, and they're really in the village. And it was really like breaking the boundaries to go and travel the world like I did. So, of course, it did change me, but... the genuine character, I think, is the I'm the same I've always been, and I love simple things. I still connect to what's the most simple in life. And my career, I never really asked for it, because I was having fun playing music, and then when they asked me to do the role of Notre Dame, I didn't even believe that it would become a success. Certainly not the success it had, because it was not France, was not a musical place. And but it changed completely.
You mentioned that you still like simple things. I know you own a beautiful, beautiful home in Quebec, surrounded by nature, and that you renovated the barn near the forest and transformed it into your personal studio. Can you please tell me what plans do you have with it?
It feels like you came already.
I would love to. Sincerely, I would love to visit your barn.
It's really fantastic, because it's a fun place. It's a little bit of my men's cave kind of thing. A lot of friends come over, and it's really now a professional studio that a lot of people want to rent, and they want to come and do projects in, because it has a real vibe. But for now, I've been like, no, I'm too independent. It's just for my own pleasure and sharing the pleasure, of course. But I love this place. It was a barn that was about to fall apart. And since I have a company that we recycle old barn woods, at first when I bought that forest, like it's like a 60 acres of, no, 125 acres actually, of land and by national parks. It's fantastic. And the barn, it was like, okay, I'm going to tear it apart. No, I cannot. It's too beautiful. So you renovated until it became the studio it is today.
What can you tell me about your most recent album, Garou Joué d'Assin? And after you give me the response, I will ask you about what you are working on right now, because you mentioned earlier that you recorded something in your own personal studio.
Joué d'Assin was a real... Joué d'Assin has always been part of my life. Like when I was very young in the car, I was singing with my parents. Joué d'Assin is one of the first songs I've ever heard. And Joué d'Assin's repertoire is so eclectic, so open. But I know that Joué d'Assin was really into old folk, American, you know, country folk music. And he was choosing a lot of that repertoire. Sometimes they were just rewriting lyrics in French, and it was becoming French pop. But what he liked the most was that really roots American folk. And so I thought about that project being like, let's take these songs and bring them back in the roots. So the barn was the perfect place for it. That's when we decided to do the last renovation to really have the professional studio. And it was great to bring back these songs. I so wish that Joe would have heard that album. I've had the chance on the concert. Julien will be there, and he told me the same. He said, I would have loved my dad to hear it, because it was really the music he loved.
Is there any song from this album that you're going to perform in Bucharest?
Certainly.
Can't wait to hear it. What future musical projects can your fans look forward? Will you get again into the studio and record new material, or you'll be touring in the next years?
I have a huge luxury is to have the studio at home and to have my producer that works for me with me full time. So we're really creating. We're taking our time. We're not doing something. We don't have a deadline. We're not working on a specific project, but we're really digging into music and new kinds. And I'm writing a lot, which I didn't do much in my life, because when I was a teenager, a lot of people told me they didn't think I would be a singer, but they thought I would be a writer. And I didn't write much because I was living 300 an hour, and I was not stopping at all, a crazy life. But now I have more time. I'm a lot more serene, my forest and my that spirit. And so I probably the pandemic helped that a little bit, you know, the starting to write stuff and seeing the world in a different perspective. But now I write a lot, so I might come eventually with my first real album that I really wrote the whole thing.
When would that be? This year till the end? Next year?
No deadline, but
year.
I have
no deadline.
Wait, for a while I've been saying I don't know why an album now, because the whole business of music, the whole way of doing things, the format, the supports, it's totally different. So I was like, maybe I'm not going to do any album anymore. But now to do my first album would be something fun. And I have enough songs, and it would be ridiculous to keep that for myself, because I think we did some great stuff, because we take a lot of time to do it, and we're really into the details. And it's way different than I've done before. Meaning it has something folk, something really roots again, but a lot more electro. So it's completely different. So we'll see how people react.
can't wait to hear it. You said that you love meeting new people, that you are a social guy. How did your time as a coach on The Voice shape your understanding of new talent and young artists?
It's a real opportunity to be in that seat and have that relation with artists. They're mainly young artists, but there are older ones, but too. But in their, if they're doing that program, is that they want to be to have a bigger career. So they want to learn, they want to understand, and that's really fascinating because from an artist to another, it's really rare that you're gonna really tell them what you think, because you would be like, oh, I'm not sure how they will react if I say, you should sing like this, you should do like this, you should. And for me, it's not an order, it's a proposition. But even from an artist to another, it's really rare that we can have that conversation. So it's great all the time. Even now, I'm gonna be director of Star Academy in Quebec and from January. So I'm gonna direct that academy of, it's another big program that was there before The Voice. And so I did 6 seasons of The Voice, and now I'm doing the director of that thing. It's going to be great again because of that, because the exchange we can have.
What advice would you give to younger artists trying to break into the music industry today?
The purpose of singing. Why do you want to perform? Why do you want to come with that song? Do you want to do it for you? To become a star? Wrong answer. Do you want to share something great? Do you want to perform the greatest you can be for people to feel something? And the purpose of why you perform is really important, I think. And a lot of people, I think they have it wrong.
After over 2 decades in the spotlight and music industry and with such a beautiful international career, what's the achievement you're most proud of? In your career or in your life?
Well, my daughter. my
Great
daughter,
answer.
But apart from my daughter, I would say my social surroundings. It's really easy today, more than ever, with social networks. It's really easy to have. Plus, now we have the algorithms that are really sending you in one direction. That's really. More narrow. I'm really proud of this, and I feel really fortunate about it, to be able to have friends in so many different worlds and spheres.
In the end, what message would you like to give to your Romanian fans ahead of your performance at the Unforgettable Festival?
I'm coming over, and we're gonna have unforgettable moments for sure. And that's it. Sharing with music is so fantastic. So we're really, I really can't wait to give all my best. À l'enfant qui viendra, qui nous ressemblera, qui sera à la fois toi et moi.